Boris FX SynthEyes 2025.5 adds a slew of new features that aim to remove friction from core matchmoving tasks. If you're looking for fast 3D matchmoving, we have new AI tools to help automatic solves, like ML motion estimation and improved control over mask ML mats. Plus, tools to help experienced matchmovers, like mesh-to-tracker parenting for fast object attachment, and a streamlined lens workflow export for consistent platform-ready results across any pipeline. Let's take a look at these and some of the other big improvements in SynthEyes 2025.5. ML Motion Estimation is a new motion tracking mode that can be found in both summary and automated features tracking. It uses a deep learning model to calculate the optical flow of pixels between frames. And this gives us an alternative way to link raw tracking data when traditional methods may fail. This is good for surfaces without much texture, like smooth walls or vehicles, or where there's heavy motion or fast camera movements. If you're failing to get good automated tracks, it's worth changing the tracking mode and trying again before moving to supervised tracking. A highly requested feature has been the ability to set up mesh geometry to follow a particular tracker. Instead of manipulating the geo into place manually, we can attach it using mesh to tracker parenting. When I have a track scene and a mesh that I've either imported or created, I can just pop into perspective view, I'll select both objects, then click Parent Mesh to Tracker in the mesh toolbar. And now my mesh is parented to that tracker. If I shift click when choosing Parent Mesh to Tracker, then my mesh will snap to the tracker's position without an offset. The mesh will now stick with that tracker, even if I refine or resolve my shot. Most shots created with real cameras and lenses will exhibit some form of lens distortion. SynthEyes has always been able to compensate for this using its lens workflow. And if you're delivering to multiple formats or different departments, then juggling their various needs was one more thing to think about. With SynthEyes 2025.5, we can now change how the lens workflow is applied directly at export time. For example, if I've calculated the lens distortion but not applied to my shot, I can do it when I run the exporter. I can even choose the same options as if I was applying it directly in the lens workflow window proper. Alternatively, if I've already run the lens workflow to apply distortion correction to my image, I can remove that distortion temporarily on export, so my solve matches my original footage. I don't need to save multiple copies of the project or temporarily unsolve my lens distortion just to export to a particular format or pipeline. And what's even better is I can use this with my multi-export too, so a whole package can be created with a single click. All of these features help to remove friction for new users and make complex workflows more robust and error-free. There are also a number of quality of life improvements too, including the ability to expand or contract mask ML garbage masks. It's a huge boon if you're encountering stray edges. Now, these are some of my favorite features in SynthEyes 2025.5. For more information, downloads, and in-depth tutorials about each one of them, head over to borisfx.com.